is with Suffolk DA Rachael Rollins. The pop quiz rolling on. When created in 1643, that's not the pop quiz, but when created in 1643, Suffolk County included several South Shore towns. So we're going to put three of them on the screen. Mm-hmm. Which one of these three communities was not among them? One was not among the South Shore, the part of Suffolk County. Was it Hull, Weymouth, or Hingham? Hull, Weymouth, or Hingham?
Weymouth?
Well, there's strike one.
Hull.
That's
knew it.
Hull.
Rats. Okay.
Okay. So you're 6 for 7. That's
all right,
pretty darn
good. All right.
Here's the final question. Massachusetts and the nation is celebrating Juneteenth this weekend, marking the end of slavery in America. The first Juneteenth happened in 1865, 2.5 years after the Emancipation Proclamation became law. So here's the question. Legendary abolitionist Frederick Douglass was in Boston on January 1st, 1863, when the proclamation became official. So where was he? Was he at the State House? Was he at Tremont Temple? Or was he at the Arnold Arboretum?
I hope he was at the State House.
He was at the Tremont Temple.
Oh, 2 for 2.
The night before, it was the Boston Music Hall.
The highest of the highs and the lowest.
6 for 8 is still very good.
It's very good. It's not great.
We may not have any other guests.
That's good point by you.
I appreciate you giving me my last 4, and I will be better next time. But anyways.
On to more serious matters.
That's right.
I want to ask you about Mikayla Miller. She's the Hopkinton teen who may have committed suicide, but many feel the investigation was not handled properly. This is not in your jurisdiction, but I'm curious as to what your take is. Was this handled right? And if not, what should have been done?
Well, there recently was a letter sent by several elected officials in the Boston area asking for the district attorney of Middlesex County to either speak with them or explain the process that happened. What I'm really proud of is in Suffolk County, had this happened here, we meet with families almost immediately, right? So when there is a suspicious death, an officer-involved death or shooting, or an in-custody death, and remember, Mikayla was found miles or a mile plus from her home under suspicious circumstances. I think, you know, we have to remember families are dealing with the most traumatic experience you could ever possibly imagine. And we have to handle them with care, right? We need the detectives or state troopers that speak to them to be culturally competent and to be decent and kind. And then we need our DA's office to respond immediately. And one of the things I make sure happens is our victim witness advocates are outstanding and great, but they make sure they meet with me as the DA as well.
And that did not happen in this particular case.
I believe ultimately it did, but I think there was a little bit of time when it happened. I'm not going to question or second guess what my colleague DA Ryan did, but I do know that this family, like most families, just want answers. And remember, the most important part of our job as DA is to get you answers as to what were the last moments, often terrible moments, mm-hmm. of your loved one's life, to get you answers. And when we can't give you those answers, it's even more hurtful when we are not responsive. So I just think this family has endured terrible pain with the loss of their loved one, but also might not have been treated as kindly as they should have been.
Well, the next item I want to get to is, what's the difference between being the Suffolk County DA and the U.S. Attorney for Boston?
I guess that I'm the Suffolk County DA, right? I don't know what that other thing is, but look, you know, I had the privilege of working hand in hand with U.S. Attorney Andy Lelling. I'm now working with U.S. Attorney Nate Mendel, and the jobs are different, uh-huh. right? The DA is an elected position. The U.S. Attorney is a presidential appointment. Almost 100% of what I do as DA is reactive to crime. We are now trying to disrupt crime and change that a little bit. The overwhelming amount of things the U.S. Attorney does are proactive. They are investigations that are long and difficult and hard. I handle 20 to 30,000 cases a year. They handle about 1,000 or less. You know, and they also are ambidextrous. They have a civil unit and a criminal unit. Mm-hmm. I only handle criminal cases. But we are law enforcement partners. We have a lot of things that we do together. The Jassy Carrera terrible kidnapping murder that happened in 2019. We worked hand in hand with them. They are handling that case, an interstate kidnapping resulting in death. Our MS-13 homicides, we worked very closely with them and they handled those cases. Human trafficking, child pornography. So we are we are shoulder to shoulder in this fight, but the jobs are a little bit different.
Could you make the transition?
I'm sorry, what now?
Oh, sorry, here you go, go first. Go ahead.
Have you had your interview yet?
Oh, stop it. Listen, I am one of three candidates that is being considered, and I am so humbled and honored to be in that group. Jennifer Serafin and I were colleagues. She is brilliant, and she runs the civil rights unit there. There's another woman that is in the running. I have not met her personally. Her first name is Deepika. She runs the Springfield office. Exceptionally qualified as well. I'm just happy to be named.
If you had to make the transition, would it be an easy transition for you?
So I will say this. I worked in that office for almost 5 years. I started in the civil division and then I went to the criminal division. I believe I am more qualified to be in that office than I thought I was to be the district attorney, only because I've worked there. But this job that I'm in right now, I promise you, and I've had some amazing jobs in my life. I've worked for the NBA Players Association, the NFL Players Association. This is the best job I've ever had in my life. And it is a hard job. But I have never been more fulfilled and humbled in the strength that I see in the people in Suffolk County, even in terrible circumstances. So I'm not going anywhere. Right now, I'm the district attorney of Suffolk County. I'm very happy to be
here. Well, then, D.A. Rollins, thank you so much for
you
being
bet.
With us
Six
on the record.
Out of eight.
Six out of eight is pretty darn good.
Pretty darn good.